Hey everyone. So about a month ago, it was prime time for pumpkin spice lattes, and of course I had to get in on it, so I made a video making a pumpkin spice latte. However, James Hoffmann did as well, and a channel called Xris did a video comparing the two. Now this had me curious because James and I both took very different approaches, and I thought it might be a good idea to try his approach. I went more for a spiced milk variation, and he went more for a syrup variation. So that's what we're doing today. This is my first try and review of James Hoffmann's ultimate pumpkin spice recipe. Alright, so let's get started. Now, to be as accurate as possible to his original recipe, I actually went online and purchased, for the most part, the same spices that he used from a company called The Spice House. You can see my selection here. There's a few very, very minor differences, but for the most part, it's all the same. And we're gonna start off now by putting together our pumpkin spice blend, or whatever you wanna call it. Yes, I'm using a scale today and we're going by grams. You're welcome. We're also using a small spice grinder because some of these spices are coming in whole. For example, the first thing we're using is cassia bark. It's a type of cinnamon that's not as commonly used, but it has a very, very delicious smell and flavor. It was my first time using it, and I'm glad I bought a bunch of this because it's definitely nice to have in the kitchen. Second off is the more commonly seen cinnamon quills. This is very recognizable as cinnamon, and just kind of break it up, measure it out, and throw it in your spice grinder. Next thing we have here is cloves. I overshot it a little bit, but I'm more of a cloves fan than I think James is, so I think that's all right. After I measured these out, again, we're just dumping it in, and then we're just gonna pulse these all together. These are the only spices that I got whole, and I wanted to kind of give them a shot at breaking down a bit before I threw in my powdered spices to finally blend up the entire mix. Speaking of which, it's powdered spice time. Starting off with ginger. I'm not giving all the listings of the exact amounts I'm using in here, but the recipe is linked as one of the top links in the description down below, so feel free to click through if you want the exact recipe. Allspice, of course, is next, a classic. Just measuring it out quickly, dumping it in, and time for our very last powdered spice. Now, James used whole nutmeg in his. I wasn't able to find that, so we have powdered nutmeg here, but I think it's a very minor difference when it all comes together, so I'm not too worried. Okay, now that we're all done with our spices, it's time to put the lid back on and give this another blend for about 30 seconds or until you have a very, very finely blended together powder, kind of similar to this. After that, feel free to give it a sniff. I was pleasantly surprised by how the cinnamon wasn't too overpowering. I was a little concerned by the amount of cinnamon, both being with two different types and with it being the majority spice, but delicious. Now, make sure you adjust your apron because it is constantly falling down and you need a new one, but you don't know where to buy one. And let's figure out how to juice a pumpkin. So this was my first predicament of the day because I don't have a juicer. So I came up with kind of this janky idea that I thought might work. Spoiler alert, it did, so let's walk through it. I cored out my pumpkin, I carved out all those seeds, I took the skin off, and then started chopping it up. And just wait. Wait for it. You're gonna see my stroke of genius here in just a second, and boom, food processor. All right, so I do have a food processor, no juicer, and for some reason my brain thought that if I could make the pumpkin as small as possible, I might be able to manually squeeze out the juice. So I just chucked a bunch of cubes in and then just blended it down to super fine particles, took it out, and stuck it in a cheesecloth because that seemed like the best option. And surprise, surprise, it worked. I didn't actually expect to get pumpkin juice. I had no idea how I was gonna do this when I started today, but look, as far as I'm concerned, that's exactly what we're looking for. I didn't yield quite as much as James, so we're gonna pare down the syrup recipe just a bit, but that's no problem because I can do math, right? So measuring out the pumpkin I have and then just matching that with equal parts filtered water. Okay, now we have to get our dry ingredients together. And it was at this moment that I realized I hadn't checked my recipe in a while, so I did that and then realized I didn't have demerara sugar. But not to be worried, usually I prefer brown sugar in spice syrups in general, so I decided to do a blend of brown sugar and white cane sugar. I didn't use all brown sugar because I didn't want that molasses flavor to be too overpowering with our spice mixture. Measured out my sugars, added in the spice mixture we're going to be infusing in the syrup, and let's head over to the stove to get this all whipped up. So, pretty simple. We're dumping in our pumpkin juice and water, all of our dry ingredients, which should be a 1-to-1 ratio if you're doing this correctly, and then just whisk it up. You're going to want to reduce this by quite a bit, so just have at it, keep whisking, keep it on kind of a low simmer, and when you're all done, it's time to run it through another cheesecloth, just to get those larger spice particles out and just have a totally wonderful clear syrup that you can then store in your refrigerator. Ultimately, you want it to have kind of this dark color. I think mine is slightly darker because I'm using a brown sugar rather than a demerara sugar, but It smelled delicious, didn't give it a taste because I wanted to wait for the final product. And let's move on to the last thing, which is our coffee-infused whipped cream. I'm of course starting out with heavy cream and also a portafilter full of medium ground coffee. Yes, a portafilter is how I'm measuring today. Vanilla paste and then a nice shaking of cane sugar. Again, we're gonna keep this on a very low heat. You don't need to keep this on for very long. It's mostly just to let the coffee kind of infuse and release some of that color and to let those sugar particles break down. All right, we're bringing it back to our hot pad and then we're running it once more through another cheesecloth. You will need many cheesecloths for this, prepare. All right, we're gonna just run this through and then I'm using a hand whisk because I don't have a whipping siphon to just blend this up into a very, very nice fluffy whipped cream that we can layer on top. All right, now to review quickly, we have our original pumpkin spice mix. We now have a pumpkin spice syrup that we can store in our fridge. And we also have this wonderful bowl of coffee infused whipped cream. As I mentioned before, I'm more of a sweet person, so I put in about between 20 and 23 grams of syrup, moved over to my machine, pulled a double shot of espresso, and then I'm using whole milk here because I figure this is a treat, might as well treat myself, but I imagine this would be quite delicious with oat milk as well. Layered on my whipped cream, and then afterwards I did a light dusting of our original pumpkin spice blend. I don't have a better name for that. Afterwards it was time to give it a test. You can't really see what I'm saying here, but if you can read lips, you can say that I say, "It's really good," and then quickly followed by, "No, this is better." This is absolutely a better pumpkin spice recipe. I give this a 9.8 out of 10. I don't want to give it a perfect 10 out of 10 because I want to leave some room for growth, but this is a fantastic recipe. Highly recommend it. Check it out. I have it linked in my description and I will see you soon. Thanks, James. I'm going to be drinking this all week. Okay, this recipe is delicious, but I want you to be prepared for the amount of dishes you will have to clean afterwards. I just kind of kept sticking stuff to the side so I didn't get in the camera, but yeah, RIP me. Okay, now I'll see you next week. Bye.